CMT has been running since, I think, 2003. So this is our 10th anniversary. Nearly every year we've been doing better than previously. Last year we finished 7th in Australia, which is our best ever finish. And overall in the world standings, we're 74th out of 501 teams. So we think that's really good. We're heading in the right direction. To build one of these cars from scratch takes about, well, at least a year. We're generally designing the car from very, very early in the year. So we've already started designing for 2013. And we build right up to pretty much the end of November before we have to send the car away to Melbourne, where the annual competition's held. The design work takes a long time, just making sure everything fits in 3D land. So we use SolidWorks as our major designing tool. More hands make light work, so we do run a bit of a training program to get new members involved and to get them up to the skill where they can start helping us building one of these cars.
Came in with the training program they were doing, went to the workshop. They showed us how to make some carbon fiber, use different tools and machinery and some of like the manufacturing processes. They gave us a shot at welding, and yeah, it was really fun. It's good to do some hands-on work. Also, it's been really good learning to use 3D modeling software, SolidWorks, which we used to design the car. Did a design unit, but haven't really had much opportunity to use it for anything else since, and you really are doing the engineering, and it's quite good.
Last year, my biggest involvement on the car was steering. We changed the steering plane down from about 30 degrees to about 11. We changed the driving position quite a lot. We laid it back, reclined it. The unsprung and suspension changed quite a lot as well. Painted, redesigned spindles, uprights, and all the wheel centers, wheel hoops, all completely changed. We managed to drop about 10 kilos out of the whole suspension system. And that's all unsprung weight as well. So that's really good to drop that weight there.
They are fairly high precision and end up being pretty highly strung car. This one makes about 80 horsepower from its engine, from 600cc restricted engine. And it gets to 100 k's an hour in about 3.2 seconds, which is rivaling your high-end Ferraris and Lamborghinis in terms of that. Turns corners ridiculously fast. We pull pretty much 2G in corners. Which is, I think, standard road cars pull about 1.2 maximum. So they just really, really built for acceleration and turning in quick. It makes them extremely fun to drive in the end.
At comp last year, we had the car we made last year behind me was seriously fast. I think the driver swap day, we were about a second off some of the top teams, but mostly came down to just prep. We just didn't have the car completed on time, so that's a big focus for this year. We can get a car done early, get everyone trained and ready, and then we can look towards 2014 early. Gives us more time, and then we're probably not, if we change a lot then, we're not going to be running late on 2014, hopefully.
This is the most practical thing I've done in the entirety of my learning experience in mechanical engineering. I think I've learned a lot more in the past 6 months than I have in the year and a half, 2 years I've been at Curtin, just purely by being able to touch and feel and work with the engineering. It's not just standing back in a lab and seeing something kind of, you know, explode. It's real and you get to see it in action. think I'll stay with the team until I graduate, maybe a little bit after, if I can stay on for a bit longer, just even to help out after I've graduated with, you know, the newer team members that are to come.
We think if we have the car done on time and drivers trained and the event prepared for well, we should actually be able to improve quite a bit on our placings from last year. That's the plan. See how it pans out.
This year we definitely plan to be top five, aiming for the podium, because after all that's what we're here for.